So number one, we know that temptation is common to all of us. He or she is our common enemy. It is our common enemy. And it is one of the problems that we will face all the days of our lives here on earth. As pilgrims here on earth, we will be tempted. So number one, it is important to recognize that temptation lurks around the corner everywhere we are. The Bible says the enemy is like a what? A roaring lion. And the word roaring lion means he's just all over. Seeking whom he may what?
Devour.
His intention is to what? Is to take us from the presence of God. His intention is to take the seed of righteousness that has been sown in us. His intention is to rob us of our Christian witness. His intention is to rob you and I of the joy we are supposed to have as Christians. His intention is to weaken us so that we don't have the strength of the Lord. But the joy of the Lord is our what? Is our strength. That is why even in the midst of the fires, we are strong. In the midst of afflictions, we can stand. When we go through diverse trials, everything, afflictions, we still can what? Smile. You say with God in the vessel, we can smile at the storm. So number one, we know that it's common to mankind, and God is faithful, and he will make a way of escape. Mark those three things. Number two, help me now again, princess, with James chapter 1, verse 13 and 14. James chapter 1, verses 13 to 14. Here we are told by James. He's the brother of Jesus, right? He's the same one? James? This one? Mm-hmm. He said, don't blame God when you are tempted. You hear that? When tempted, no one should say, God is what? Tempting me. For God cannot be tempted by what? Evil, nor does he tempt anyone. So let's forget about that. Verse 14. But each one is tempted when by his own evil desire he is dragged away and enticed. Why do you think I picked up the gun? Well, I was what? I was violent. Because in my heart, I had no love. In my heart, I was arrogant. I thought nobody should cross my family. In my heart, I thought I should defend them. That was my personality. And so the devil what? Used it to his advantage. I was enticed by my own personality. I was dragged into doing something wrong because that was my temperament. There is something that I, beside going through the spiritual transformation, this is more psychological, there is something that I've been through my life, I've gone through my life, and it's called behavior modification. I'm taking you to another level now, beside the spiritual thing. Behavior modification. One should be able to say, this behavior that I have only brings to me sorrow. It brings to me pain. It is not helping my cause. It is only making me what? It is only bringing me defeat. It has not done any good to my life, nor the people what, around me. It is a destructive what? Behavior. When you come to recognize that, then you what? You intentionally engage in what will what? Make your life better. You hearing me, young ones? Hello? When was the last time you think? Yes. You know, we live in an age where people don't think. Hey, young ones, when was the last time you really had an introspection, deep thoughts within yourself, facing the person within you, call your name and say, my name is not who I see in the mirror, your real self is within. And when was the last time you talked to that person within, or whenever you see that person, you just shun it and say, you stay there. Because you know what? You are projecting one picture outside there, and deep down in your heart, you have another person there. But you need to face that person and deal with that person. When was the last time you really had a good thought? Don't blame God when you are what? Tempted. It only was in your situation. Of course, as I said, temptation comes to us in various forms. Let me say this, when you are about to send, before you click the button to send some news to a friend, and that news is about another person, are you going to think about it? Will it bring disgrace or shame to the person? Will it malign the image of the person? Will it be something that will tarnish the person's reputation? Yeah. And what justifies your intention? Why are you doing it? Yeah. Oh, it will help to strengthen the person. Whatsoever is good, whatsoever is noble, whatsoever is of a good report, think about these things. Because you have been washed. You've been cleansed. You've been sanctified. You have been changed. You are not the same person. You are a child of the Most High God. And whatsoever you do, reflect who you are and who He is. He is holy. You know, most times when we talk about temptation, anytime you talk about temptation, the first thing that comes to mind is fornication. That's as far as I see, it's just a teaser. Anytime you talk about it, everything has to do with sex. So that's it. They say sex sells. We make headlines. But you know, if we are able to deal with those little things, it will help us to conquer the big things. Because we will develop our integrity, a character that is pure, sound mind. Because to me, a gossiper is as dangerous as a murderer. My young people, my brothers and sisters, the next moment when you are about to do something, think about it. Listen to the voices. And know which one is of God. And do what is right. Yield not to temptation. For yielding is what is sinful. It is not the temptation that comes your way, because we just learned that temptation is common to all. But it is the one submitting to the temptation. It is actually committing or not committing. What is evil here? What does the Bible say about temptation? A temptation is a common enemy to believers. And that we are not to blame God when we are tempted. How do we endure temptation? We go straight into what Jesus said, Mark chapter 14, verse 38. Mark, say pray, right? Watch and what?
Pray.
Seek divine intervention. Do not fight temptation, because you can't fight temptation. Don't wrestle with it. God's intervention. Lord, take the wheel. I hear that song. It makes a lot of sense. Just take the wheel, because you know what? If you are driving through storm, you just can't make it by yourself. But Jesus knows every way through the storm. Because he makes storms. He's the master of storms. So say, Lord, I need you. I need thee every hour. Every moment. I cannot work through this situation on scars unless you come to my rescue. I want to do what is right. I want to please you. I want to do what will glorify your name, Lord. My flesh is weak in my mind, and all that I see around me, it is pointing me to do the opposite. Lord, just come in. And it's when you are able to sing the song, it is no longer I that liveth, but Christ lives in me. But he will take charge, and he will walk through the storm. He will walk through the temptation. He is our strength when we are weak. My grace is sufficient, and my power is made perfect in your weakness. Lord, that is why we pray. That is why we pray. When we pray, we are only accepting the fact that God is almighty. Amen. Not only pray, there are times that, and again, as a wise soldier, you must know which armor to use at a particular time. You know, soldiers use the armory according to the nature of the war. If they need to use fighter jets, you know, it's a very serious thing. If they need to use drone troops, you know, it's just one little something. If they have to go with just papaya. Oh, we have a soldier here. You know. I was amazed when one guy demonstrated yesterday that you can actually hide AR in your pants. Nobody knows. This one gun like this. And the guy pulled it out and he had an ammunition of what, 210 rounds of ammunition with him. That's how dangerous one man can be. And you want to go and face the enemy just like that? You need to apply scripture when necessary to liberate yourself. When Jesus was tempted, he looked at the devil Satan and he said, it is written. And what happened? The Bible says, after Jesus said it is written, the devil left him. Because God's word is final. There is authority in the word of God. And when you use the word, it's what? It is sealed. And that is why we need to know the word of God. The psalmist David said, I have hid my what? Hid my heart so that I may not sin against thee. But I want to take it a little further. When you hide the word of God in your heart, you will be able to draw from it when you need it. And apply the right scripture to the situation. The marvel that we often have when a doctor makes you well is to know the right, to give you the right prescription. And then you jump in, bubbling again, and you're all right. Come on, Christians, you're supposed to be wiser than the doctors. Know your word, know the scripture. I was young, I quoted that scripture last week. I was young, now I'm old. Never seen the righteous forsaken, blessed of the earth. And so at any time in your life, if the devil wants to make you feel like you are forsaken, that you are left alone, throw it right back on his face and let him understand that this is the word of God, that he has promised never to leave me nor forsake me. seed, let him bread, and today we speak prosperity upon our children. We speak blessings upon our children, that God will lift them up. For God did not only create them to become statistics, but to be known. Every one of you, that is your heritage. Walk therefore in it, run in it, live in it. Psalm 73. I love that scripture. I read it from the beginning. The psalm is Asaph, or Asaph, whatever you call him, A-S-A-P-H. He had a very serious situation. He almost lost it all. He said, I almost lost my foothold. You know, I like the classic way in which he describes his situations. You know, when you are standing and you lose your balance, when you lose your balance, what happens? You fall. See, I almost dropped. When I looked and I realized that my neighbor don't go to church, but he seemed to be all right. Every day I hear him laughing in his house and having parties. I just came from the hospital. I spent 2 weeks. I have never seen the ambulance come for him yet. What wrong with me? Well, it looks like I need to join them so that I can smile too. Say they are arrogant when they speak like, hey, they are Mr. Mention. Daddy, daddy, done man. You know? I saw something somewhere in the road and I mentioned it to somebody and they said, no, you can't touch that man, you know. One of those big guys there. I said, okay. One day somebody will touch him. Because there is a real dumb man. And he's God.
Amen.
And when he touch you, money can't help. Your friends can't help. Your influence can't help. Nothing can help but mercy. God is awesome. God is wonderful. If God is not alive, some people will just come and buy you and sell you and do whatever they want. And they will feel so high up. I want you to spend time in reading this Psalm 73. He said, you know what happened, what liberated me? I went to church and I heard a scripture read. And it brought to me clearly what the end of those people will be. And I realized that I was in a better position than them. Be careful what you look at. Be careful who you look at. Be careful of looking at the superficial things. I told you that I know someone who used to sit in an air-conditioned vehicle that, to me, when I sit in, I was freezing and they were sweating. Their hearts were boiling because, you know what, they were surrounded by all kinds of problems. My jacket covers a lot of things, you know. And when you see a man wearing jacket every day and tie down and say, oh, poor me! Take it easy. The best jacket to wear is a garment of salvation. And it will be well with your soul. When you are tempted, how do you endure it? Apply scripture. And I want to speak specifically to our young people these days because I think they are so busy with the smartphones that
you don't even read scripture again.
Amen. I want you to begin to read your Bible. Read it. Get back to the Bible, read it. Understand it. So that you can use it. Let it be your compass. Let it be your guide. Let it speak to your actions. Let it be the word that influences your decisions. This that I am compelled to do is against my biblical principles. I won't do it because I seek to glorify none but God. Yield not to temptation. We are tempted. Those who have become addicted to alcohol, they were tempted, tempted, and tempted. They yielded, and now they are out of control. Sometimes we are tempted to eat plenty. And we have to say to ourselves, no, 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 that. Go easy. I mean, you know what I mean. Let's face the truth. It is a temptation. Late in the night, you get up and you hear my whole heap of pork and so on. You know what happened? So you understand that temptation is a common enemy to us. We are tempted in many ways. Some of us is not food. Some of us we drink too much. And I'm not just talking about. I'm not talking about alcohol. Juice. You just drink and drink and drink and drink. And all when your doctor say, take it easy. They say, boy, that is my weakness. You love juice? I love water. Yeah, so I think it has come right home to us now to understand that temptation comes to us in different forms. The young ones, hello, when you are tempted to sleep too long instead of getting up and studying the government books, you sleep your life away. What does the Bible speak about sleeping too much? Is it a little what? And what? And your poverty what? Draws near. So you sleep away your life. And when graduation time comes, sometimes not even social paper you get. You not get money. Too late. One a friend of mine used to say there is more sleep after death. Don't worry about it now. When you die, you go and sleep. Nobody will wake you up. But until then, let your hands be what? Busy. Let your feet be busy about your master's business. For God has given you the knowledge to learn and learn and learn and become fruitful here on earth so that you can impact humanity the best way you can. Don't just become a census. And in this church, you the young ones have so many people to look up to. So you have no excuse. You have no excuse. You need to excel, and I am not going to take anything less from any one of you. I mean it, until I leave here, you're going to hear me, and get tired of hearing me, nothing but excellence. And I know you can do it. Don't tell me that your head, your skull is too hard. If it's hard, come and let me hammer it for you. All what you need to do, you can read, read. If you can't read, then go and learn how to read. Let's move on. Hello? when you leave here today, you begin to think,